Alright, what's up guys? So, me and Avery are currently driving. I'm actually just pulling out. See, anybody coming? Nope. Alright, so right now we're gonna go take a load of metal to a nearby scrapyard and get some money off of it for gas. So, took in as much as I can on a quote-unquote break with YouTube, and I was actually going to take a lot longer, but I've noticed some very sad comments, and I'm saying that nicely, on the last couple of videos I did, and the problem is that everybody, I won't say everybody, but a lot of people, this is comments on my YouTube, on my Facebook page, Messenger, people think that pit bulls are just these dangerous dog breeds, and they're really not. It was my fault for what Aria did. You see, I already knew that Aria was abused before I got her. Hold on. I already knew she was abused. I just didn't think it was I didn't think she was gonna do what she did. You know, I didn't think, like, I guess I just didn't think that dog abuse as she was gonna attack another dog. And I say that because for the most part, she's always been good with Xena. I mean, other than them, you know, roughhousing in the backyard, they've never fought each other. That's the crazy part, and I'm going the wrong way, like an idiot. Anyways, they've never fought each other, so that's the reason why I never kept them separated when I left home, because I just didn't expect something to happen. So, yeah, I take full responsibility for it, but at the same time, that doesn't mean that you should go and blame pit bulls for being the reason that she did what she did, because that's just stupid. That's like saying, in a way, that's kind of like a race thing. That's like saying that all black people are evil because you always see them on the news, you know, robbing and murdering and shit like that, even though white and Mexican people do the same damn thing, you know. And obviously you see pit bulls on the news with the same deal, but they did that same shit with Dobermans and Rottweilers and German Shepherds, and I'd rather have all those dogs with me than, you know, like a poodle or a chihuahua, especially chihuahuas. I'm actually scared of chihuahuas. Like, legit scared of chihuahuas. So, don't blame Aria for her breed. Blame it on my stupidity for not being able to see what would have happened. And blame the previous owner for the shit they pulled on her. So, that's the only reason I really wanted to make this video. My god, with the small ass roads, it looks like we're gonna get into a collision. I've had, just last week, I think, or the week before, I was on my way to a friend's house to go chat with him. He needed me to come by the house or something. And we're going down the road, some of y'all from Lufkin will know it, Homer Alto, that leads into the Hudson area. And as I'm going down, a lot of the people that live on that road use it to park a lot of their cars. Like, there's some people on that road alone who only have, I'm sorry, who have more than like 4 or 5 cars, maybe even more, that they're working on. So they'll park their cars on the side of the road, and when there's another car comes, especially at night, it makes it hard for me to try to stay on the road, because most people who go down Homer Alto like to speed a lot. so when they're speeding and there's cars on the side of the road, that makes me fucking nervous. Because then it's like, I don't, in a situation like that, I really don't know what to do. You know, I don't know if I stay on the road, if I'm gonna, you know, wreck with the person coming. I don't know if they're gonna veer off and wreck into somebody, or if I'm gonna veer off and wreck into somebody. So I ended up getting on the side of the road to try to avoid a collision. Whiskey River. To try to avoid a collision, and the truck goes by, and as I'm trying to pull out, I get stuck in mud. I'm stuck in the mud for like an hour and a half. I tried calling Aaron. Aaron wouldn't come out because he was asleep, and he keeps his phone off silent for some God knows unknown reason. And then James, who I was gonna go visit, he tried to pull me out, but he didn't have an actual tow cable, so he used a what do they call those? A ratchet strap to try to pull me out, and that broke the strap in half. Sorry, James, for watching this. And then, so we had to call another friend of ours, who's friends with both me and Aaron. And he ended up coming all the way from the town of Corrigan to come pull me out. And yeah, that was a very big embarrassment for me. Let's see, what's our weight? 390. Is there anybody in there? I don't think anybody's even in there. Nope, nobody's in there. I hate it when there's nobody in the office. Like, seriously now, come on. Get your shit together. Where is everybody? Alright. Hold on one second. Alright. So we just got just scrapped a bunch of tin and such. Only made $6, but that's enough for gas money to do whatever else I was gonna do. So anyways, I don't remember what I was saying. But I'm gonna start doing more driving vlogs. I'm actually holding, my phone's being held by, it's being held by the sun reflector. There's a little sleeve pocket or something on it. I guess later today, when I get, if I get this up, this video uploaded, I'll go ahead and do a tour of the truck, because the way I have it right now, I have it to the point where I can actually sleep in the back over here. And Avery herself is becoming a very good ride dog. Both her and Marmaduke are really good at it, but Avery's a lot better. I guess, like, with Marmaduke, the reason why I don't let Marmaduke a lot of the things that the girls would have normally done, and this isn't anything against him, it's just the fact that, if I, for example, like, last time he was riding with me, I had to clean the truck, one of the seats on the truck, because he ended up pissing everywhere, even though he used the restroom outside, but he was so excited, he just couldn't contain himself. So it's kind of hard for me to do things with Marmaduke compared to like Avery and whatever other female dogs I have, or would have. So I'm trying to make it where it's like Marmaduke friendly. I don't know how I'm gonna do that, but I mean, it's worth a shot if you ask me, really, because I love that boy to death, you know. Ooh, I'm coming too tight. There we go. Yeah, I never really thought I'd get my license, let alone a truck to drive it with. You know, I just figured I'd be doing everything by foot or bike ride or train or whatever. but I really didn't think it was even gonna be this fun, because I was so nervous driving around other people. I still get nervous. I don't even like driving like certain parts of Angelina County here. I don't like driving at during the night because people get so fast. Like, I'm comfortable with a speed under 60 miles an hour because I'm used to it, especially when I'm out driving with Aaron. But if it's over 60, I don't know. I could try, but I don't feel comfortable with it. You know, like, this coming Saturday, we're supposed to go, me and Avery, and I think Marmaduke, I'll probably bring Marmaduke with us. We're supposed to go to up to Jefferson again. And this time, instead of staying, I'm just grabbing a bunch of my stuff I have in storage over there. A lot of my old firefighting gear and equipment, and military uniforms, military rations, camping equipment, stuff like that, that I need. And we're gonna go Saturday, but instead of following the usual highway routes like I would if I was hitchhiking, goddamn, people gotta drive slowly in a lane that isn't supposed to be slow. Come on. Anyways, what was I saying? Oh yeah. Instead of driving on the highways and such, I'm gonna go ahead and drive on like county roads and back roads to get there, you know, try to enjoy the drive and such. I really do not feel comfortable driving on a highway as far out past Angelina County, you know. That's right, my turn signal. So yeah, we're gonna leave Saturday. We'll leave like maybe 5 o'clock in the morning, and then we'll probably make it back in time to help out at the rink if I need to. Come on, dude. Why does everybody drive so fucking slow around here? Sorry. My God, it's not even Sunday. Go! Isn't there like a time old people don't drive past 10? It's nearly 1, I think. I don't know. I can't look at my phone. No offense to you old people. Sorry. Anyways, yeah, like I said, it's become a lot more fun. I've been able to scrap a lot more metal and make more money off of it. People are just throwing metal on the side of the road, and I guess it's because metal prices aren't as good as they were pre-COVID era, if you can even say that. I'm gonna take this right, so I do not want to be stuck behind this guy. But I've also been able to, you know, get more supplies in from dumpster diving. We went dumpster diving last night, and I guess I should have filmed it. We ended up finding like 5 or 6 different cartons of eggs. Oh, speaking of eggs, we ended up getting a second flock in from a friend of ours for about $100. So we got 5 hens and another rooster, and they're separated from our main flock. Oh shit, am I going the wrong way? Shit, I think I am. Fuck. God damn it. I didn't see the sign. I hope I don't get pulled over for this. Damn it. And I've been coming down here for years. I figured I would have known it by now. Oh, this is so embarrassing. Oh my God. Oh my God, this is embarrassing. Now I gotta wait for these cars to go. Shit. Ah, fuck. So anyways, yeah, we got a new flock in. The garden's been expanded even more, which I'll show you guys. I ended up, I got a grape tree and a blueberry tree. And the grape tree is gonna be planted, once it's matured enough where I can replant it to a different spot, I'm gonna plant it over Zena's grave and name it after her. The Zena grape tree or something along that line. And God damn it, people. Anyways, the reason why I wanted to do grapes, I mean, I could have done the blueberry tree, but I didn't have it yet. But the reason why I wanted to do grapes was, as I mentioned on a Facebook post, it's going to be as sweet and nice as Xena is, which is why I wanted to put a grape tree over her grave. Because then, you see, and this is what I want to do once I do pass on from whatever, is I want to go ahead and get myself cremated. And once I get cremated, if I can do this on a legal standard, you know, with a lawyer and stuff like that, all my possessions are going to be divided between my sister, my younger sister, April, who really is the only one close to me, and then the rest of my stuff will go to... Okay, well, here's the thing, so y'all can better understand it. I am currently dating somebody. I'm actually heading over to see her now. I can see her truck at her job. We are talking about wanting to adopt a child or two. You know, we thought about the childbirth thing, and she really doesn't want to go with it because, A, there's too many children that need to be adopted anyways. So bringing another child in the world just doesn't seem the right thing to do. And B, she just can't stand the thought of childbirth, which I don't blame her. I really can't either. Hell, the closest I could probably get to it was when Avery gave birth, and even then, that kind of freaked me out a little bit. Huh, Ava Lee, you wanna come say hi? Look, come here, come, look, there you are. Okay, back up. I gotta drive, you know. But, I'm thinking, okay, so I'm gonna give parts of my stuff to my sister. So like I said, she's the only one I'm really close with. I mean, I'm close to my younger brother too, but he doesn't want anything I have. And then whatever kids me and Caitlin decide to adopt, that the rest of my stuff will go to them if they want it. But I just can't stand the thought of all the stuff I've collected over the years, all this railroad and hoboing stuff, and this military gear and equipment, and all this other stuff. You know, this home, the homestead itself, I can't stand seeing it, you know, being, like, basically thrown in the dumpster, you know. I swear, the light at Timberland and Denman is, like, the slowest red and green light there is. There we go. Hang on, Avery. Yep, Caitlin's here. Sweet. Alright, well, that does it for this video now. I'll see y'all in the next video, hopefully giving you guys a tour. So, peace.